In 1957, biochemist John Kendrew revealed the first atomic protein structure using a technique called X-ray crystallography. This method became one of the most important tools for structural biologists. In the first step of X-ray crystallography, a desired protein is purified and concentrated as a crystal. Forming this highly ordered array is often the most difficult part of the entire process. The crystal is then placed into the path of a high-intensity X-ray beam and rotated. The X-rays deflect off the electrons surrounding the crystal's atoms, scattering before striking a detector. The resulting diffraction pattern is then transformed by a computer into a 3D map of the protein's electron density. From here, it's like solving a jigsaw puzzle. Amino acids from the known protein sequence are fitted into the 3D map to produce a structural model of the protein. Initially, researchers solved this jigsaw puzzle by hand, using balls and sticks to construct the models. Later, computational tools were developed to accelerate the task.
The effort to doing this is enormous. You can think of it as something like $100,000 in expense, a couple of years of a PhD student's time, really an enormous investment to get even a single structure.
In the 1970s, a consortium of researchers started the Protein Data Bank, or PDB, to catalog determined structures. The location of each atom inside a protein structure was recorded as a set of three-dimensional coordinates. Today, the PDB contains the structural data for more than 200,000 proteins. Newer technologies like nuclear magnetic resonance and cryo-electron microscopy, or cryo-EM, allow researchers to probe larger proteins as well as complex molecular assemblies. But despite these imaging advances, much of how linear strings of amino acids actually fold into their 3D functional shape remains a mystery.